I'm excited about this one because I love Wireshark. When I was first introduced to Wireshark, my mind was completely blown because I'd never really gotten to see what networking looked like to the computer. What kinds of things is the computer seeing as data is being sent back and forth? And seeing it in Wireshark helps put it all together. And so we'll talk a little bit now about what Wireshark is, what it does, and then we'll go into a little bit of a demo, and you can download Wireshark for yourself. You can play around with it and see what's going on your network. See what your computer sees as data is being sent around on your network. So after this video, you should be able to answer these two questions. What does Wireshark show you? And how can you use Wireshark to understand network traffic? Both of these we will cover right now. So Wireshark is a free, which is awesome, free is great, open source, which is also awesome, which means it'll pretty much always be free, GUI packet analyzer. Let's break down those words. GUI means graphical user interface. There are other packet capture tools and packet analyzer tools that are done at the command line and don't use a graphical user interface. So this makes it easy for anybody to download Wireshark, test it out, try it out. If you want to look into it, you can get TCP dump and play around with the command line and doing all that kinds of stuff, and that's fantastic. We're going to do it with the GUI because it's way easier for beginners to understand what's going on. Packets. We talked about packets, what packets are. This is a tool for analyzing those packets, which means it can sniff the packets, which means look at the packets, gather them together, put them all in a nice little interface for you to look at, and then you can look through and analyze statistics. Look at what's going on your network, what those packets are that are being sent and received, and you will see lots of them. So let's get down to business. That's the basics of what Wireshark is. Let's go to the packets. All right, let's take a look at Wireshark and what it can do for us. So when you first load up Wireshark, what you're gonna see is a list of network interfaces connected to your computer. And there's gonna be a bunch of them, probably not as many as I have here, but you're gonna see a bunch. And each of those interfaces represents some way that your computer has to do network communications. More than likely, what you're going to see is something that's either Wi-Fi if you're connected to Wi-Fi, or something that mentions Ethernet if you're connected via a hardwired Ethernet connection. And you want to make sure that you select the right one, because if you pick the wrong one, then you're not going to see as much traffic as you might like to see, because it's not listening on the right interface. Because what Wireshark does is it tells the network interface itself to send all traffic, in addition to wherever it's going to do its job, in addition to your web browser or whatever, it's going to send all traffic to Wireshark so that you can look at it. Well, if you pick the wrong one, then all that traffic on that, there isn't going to be any traffic on that interface. So what you're looking for is the interface that represents however you're connected to the internet. If it's Wi-Fi, choose Wi-Fi. If it's Ethernet, choose Ethernet. It's going to be whichever one probably has the most spiky looking line. I've got a lot of loopback traffic here, ignore that. We're gonna do Ethernet. So once you do that, make sure you select the right interface, click the little blue shark fin to start a capture, and you're gonna see a whole bunch of stuff coming across your network. This is every single packet that your network card is seeing. So if I load up a page, if I load up a website here, I'm gonna load up a new website, and this is a website I haven't been to today, so you're gonna see a whole bunch of traffic associated with that. You're gonna see a whole bunch of protocols, probably some that you recognize, maybe a bunch that you don't. So once you've let that run for a little bit, go ahead and stop the capture, and then we're gonna make this window a little bit bigger and look through and see what's going on. So this here is our Wireshark interface, and the Wireshark interface shows you kind of three different panels of information. In the top panel, you've got that list of packets that we saw scrolling through as things were loaded up. So we captured 1,155 packets in the 32 seconds that I was capturing packets there. So there's a lot of stuff going across our network. In the middle pane, you've got the data for a single packet. So whichever packet I have selected up here, is the details for that packet are down here. So I could click on the Dropbox LAN Sync Discovery Protocol. You can see that right here. And down below, you've got all the information for the Dropbox LandSync discovery protocol right here. And then in the very bottom, you've got the binary version of that same data. So in the middle, you've got where Wireshark takes the data from the packet and kind of filters it out, makes it look nice, parses out the bits of information that you might see, that you might want to look at and be interested in. And it really, it's the same bits of information that your network stack has parsed to do its job, whether IP addresses or transport layer, Ethernet at the data link layer, any of these addresses. That's exactly the data that your network stack has looked at. And then at the very bottom, instead of the really pretty part, you've got that same data, but just in straight binary. And this binary is represented as hexadecimal, which we could talk about some other time, or you could look it up. But this is the ones and zeros that went across the network at the physical layer. And you can look at these, and you can click on them, and it'll show you kind of what each of these sections represents. So in this case, we've got a number that's represented as binary here. So on the left is the information as hexadecimal. On the right is an attempt to take that hexadecimal information and turn it into characters that you would recognize. And sometimes that's going to make sense. In this case, you could see display name and namespaces and some things that you might recognize. Other times, if you're sending a picture across, you're going to see a bunch of dots that don't mean anything, or just a bunch of gobbledygook that doesn't mean anything. And that's completely normal. So let's find, what we can do is apply a filter here. So I want to find that website that I visited. I want to see what happens when I visit a website, what data gets transferred across the network. And to do that, I can apply a filter. And the filters are very picky. They're very specific in the way that they are formatted. But I know off the top of my head that there's one for HTTP, which is the Hypertext Transfer Protocol, which is exactly how the web works. So I can pull up HTTP, and because it was an unencrypted website, I can see the entire HTTP process. So I see here that we have an HTTP GET request, and when we talk about HTTP and application layer protocols, you'll understand better what that means. But we have an HTTP GET request, and I can look down below here, and I'm going to fold up these kind of subsections. We can look at the frame and get information about all of the data that went across the wire. We can look at the Ethernet and see the Ethernet destination MAC address and the source MAC address, which in this case is my device. And that's that physical address of my device. We can look at the IP version 4 and see the IP addresses. And if we look down here, we'll see the IP source address of 10.25.91.19, that's my address, and the destination address of 13.225.141.73. So, and then there's a whole bunch of other information here, and this is all that envelope that IP wraps things up in, that the network layer or the internet layer is wrapping things up in. And then we've got the transmission control protocol, TCP, which is our transport layer, which here's that envelope. And we can see the source port and the destination port and a whole bunch of other information that may not make any sense right now. And then finally, we've got HTTP, which is the application layer protocol. And this is what it's sending across the wire. And if we click on that, it'll pull it up down below so we can see exactly what it looks like and where that falls inside of our entire data. Inside of our entire connection here. So that starts right here. All that stuff before is all header information for the transmission control protocol, the IP protocol, which is redundant, but that's okay, and the Ethernet protocol. And so you'll see all of that and all this information and all this, you know, if you're familiar with it, great. If you're not, that's fine. Maybe take some time and look something up. So find something in a list that you're not familiar with. Find something in your packet capture that you're not familiar with and figure out what it means. What is the user agent? What's that telling us? What is the accept header telling us? And in response, we get this HTML, and this is a whole bunch of gobbledygook. And you can see the data. So Now that you've seen HTTP, let's go ahead and click right here on the little red X to clear that. And let's look at something else. Let's say DNS. Maybe we want to see what DNS requests were being sent and received from our computer. And you can see here that there's a lot of them. So we have a request for google.com, a request for fonts.gstatic.com, a request for client6.google.com, a request for encryptedtbn0.gstatic.com. And you can see all of those here and look at them here and see the data that's being transmitted, see the responses for those. And there's a lot. As you can tell, it takes a lot of DNS requests to make things work. And when we talk about DNS, all of that will start to make sense. But what I want you to do is just start to get familiar with what's going on here and start to get comfortable Googling things or Binging them or DuckDuckGoing them, whatever your browser of choice is. So take a look around and see if you can find something you're not familiar with and see if you can figure out what it is. So the Dropbox LAN Sync Discovery Protocol, who knows what that is? Obviously it's something to do with Dropbox and syncing over the local area network. Just take a look around. Take a look and see what's out there. What is gratuitous ARP? What is LLMNR? What is ARP? What is MDNS? What is UDP? What is NBNS? You know, there's a lot of stuff that you're not going to be familiar with. And the more you learn about networks, the more stuff you're going to be comfortable with. But I also want you to be comfortable not being comfortable and not understanding something and saying, oh, I don't know what that is. Maybe I'll take some time to figure it out. Or maybe I could just ignore it for now and hope that at some point along the line it starts to make sense, because it's not relevant, because there's so much stuff that we don't know. And that's Wireshark. Make a capture of your own. If you need to visit an unencrypted website, neversSL.com. If you just type in neversSL.com in your browser, you're going to pull that right up. It's helpful to visit an unencrypted website, because if you visit encrypted websites, they don't show up as HTTP. They just show up as TCP because everything else is encrypted. And so there's not as much to look at. So find an unencrypted website, maybe make one yourself, or visit neversSL.com. Visit the website, check it out, and look at the requests that are going across your network, and just start to get a grasp for how Wireshark works and how traffic works on your network. And that is Wireshark. All right, that was awesome. I told you I love Wireshark. It's so cool. So much awesome stuff. So now that you've seen Wireshark, I hope that you take some time, download Wireshark for yourself, do a packet capture, see what you can see on your network, because you're going to see a lot of stuff that you may not understand. And seeing stuff you don't understand helps you understand what you don't understand, which helps you ask the right questions later on. So download Wireshark, run a packet capture. I know it feels like it should be like almost illegal to have that level of access to the stuff that's going on in your computer, but it's really awesome. You can do it. Download it. Look at it. It's cool. Check it out. All right. So check yourself a little bit before we go. What is Wireshark? And what insights do you gain about the network traffic on your computer from viewing that Wireshark packet capture? And there's going to be a lot of stuff you don't understand right now. So don't worry about that. As you learn more about networking, things will start to make sense, and you'll look back at your Wireshark packet captures and be like, oh, I get what that is now. Oh, I see this piece that we talk about. Oh, that piece right there. That's that thing right there that I saw that I had no idea what it was. All of this will slowly start to coalesce as you learn more about networking, but you got to start somewhere. And I wanted you to start from seeing what goes on your network. So what insights do you gain?